Ollie Campbell here. Without the mop of red hair that I had in my playing days, which those of you with long memories just might remember, the Charitable Trust of the RFU was founded in 1978, 32 years ago, obviously, this year. It was founded to support seriously injured rugby players in every way possible. I think its very existence is a great tribute and testament to the RFU, as they are one of the very first unions in the world to actually establish such a trust. At the moment, there are 36 injured players on the island of Ireland. The oldest is 67, going on 68. The youngest is 16. There are actually 21 under the age of 21. I had many inspirations as a young man growing up, not least Jack Kyle, my dad's all-time sporting hero, Mike Gibson, my own sporting hero, many others, not just confined to rugby, not just confined to sport. But I can honestly say, with my hand on my heart, the biggest inspiration of my adult life has been the injured players of the RFU and their carers. These are real-life, unsung heroes, each and every one. So I'd like to thank the Taverners, on behalf of Jeff Smith, who is the chairman of the Charitable Trust Committee, and all the committee members, just like to thank you most sincerely for all your support in the past, and hopefully this will continue in the future as well. It is deeply, deeply appreciated. I hope you have a great day. I'm sorry I'm not there with you. I'll take this opportunity to wish you all a very happy Christmas and a fulfilling 2011 in everything.
Well, it was my great pleasure to accept the bus from the Lord's Taverners last year. And I'm here to thank you all for 8,000 kilometres of community access and inclusion for children with disabilities in Cork. The bus arrived in late August. It was a godsend because it replaced a vehicle which was on its last legs. Coming to and from our facilities in Cork every day, but allowing people there to participate in sports programs, in community access programs. And I think that's particularly relevant because there's a new Cork County Sports Partnership and a bocce league. And without the Lord's Taverners bus, we wouldn't have been able to participate in that. So it's been a joy, and we look forward to many years, many more thousands of kilometres of inclusion for everybody in Cork. So, Gormila Mahabat.
Say a very sincere thank you to the Lord Taverners.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
A million thanks to the Lord Taverners.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
The Lord Taverners, thank you.